And I'm here with Dodgers prospect DJ Peters. DJ, first off, right off the bat, besides your size looking like a linebacker, first thing you see is that flow. How long have you been growing this?
Since 2015, after the Rangers drafted me after my freshman year at Western Nevada Community College, I kind of just, you know, said, you know, whatever with it, kind of just let it grow out. Growing up, I always had long hair, and then when I was in high school, kind of just always had like a buzz cut, and then, just, you know, decided to grow it back out, and now I love it. So.
It's your staple, it's your thing. Will you ever cut it? Will you ever buzz it?
You know, sometimes I think about it here and there, but you know, I've done, you know, pretty well with it, so might just keep around for a little longer.
Now let's talk a little baseball. You're an LA kid, grew up loving the Dodgers, and now you're playing for them. It all comes full circle. Take me through this story, this dream come true for you.
Yeah, you know, grew up a Dodgers fan ever since I was 6 years old, you know, going to games with my parents and, you know, my grandfather. And so I still remember my very first Dodger game, and, you know, growing up, my favorite player was Sean Green, and, you know, to, you know, hear my name called in the 2016 MLB draft by the Los Angeles Dodgers was a dream come true and kind of like no-brainer for me. So it's an absolute blessing, like I said before, and you know, I absolutely love it here.
Take me through draft day. What were the emotions like? What were you doing?
I was at my sister's 4D ultrasound, actually, with my whole entire family, and you know, I kind of told myself, you know, I was gonna be with my family that day, whether it was, you know, at home, at, you know, lunch or whatever it may be. And turns out it was at my my sister's ultrasound, and you know, we see my niece up on the screen, and then, you know, we hear my name get called, which is a very special moment, because, you know, I got drafted by, you know, my favorite team growing up, and then, you know, seeing my niece up on the screen was kind of just like a 2-in-1, very great day.
What a great day for her too, the memories, you can tell that when she's older. So what are you working on here at AFL?
Kind of just, you know, working on the things that I need to work on, and kind of, you know, like all my weaknesses and, you know, all my strengths, kind of just, you know, polish up my game a little bit, and, you know, learn a little bit from, you know, other coaches outside of the Dodgers organization, and kind of just learning from, you know, my new teammates from, you know, different organizations. You know, you don't get to play against these guys during the season, so. You know, it's a blessing to know in order to play with guys that, you know, you want to play with on a daily basis.
Speaking of things that you need to work on or that you're learning, what's something that you can take from last year that you thought that you excelled at?
You know, kind of just, you know, staying consistent, you know, learning my body, you know. Yeah. It was my first full season, and I learned a lot, you know, nutrition, health, getting in the weight room, you know, as much as I can, and staying flexible, at the same time being able to play every day. So, you know, here I only get to play twice a week, which is something new for me. You know, coming from playing 130 something games out of 140. So, I love it. It's fun. You know, if I had it my way, I would play every day out here, but you know, I understand the situation that I'm in.
Something that you just mentioned that I think is so interesting is the nutrition aspect of it. Is there something you can share with me that maybe other people can start doing, or something that you've learned? I mean, you live and breathe this. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So the Dodgers organization is everything organic. So, so everything we eat is all organic, even to the milk, to the juices, everything we do. So, you know, that is something that I've carried myself into during the off season last year, and it's something that I'll carry myself into the off season this year, because I just feel so much better when I eat that kind of stuff, and, you know, making sure I eat enough. You know, I'm a big guy, so you know, during the off season I eat about 6 meals a day, so you know, making sure I eat enough, and then you know drink enough water too. So yeah, man, I love it. It's fun.
Who would you say that you mimic your game after?
You know, a lot of people say Jason worked just because my hair and stuff, but you know, to be honest with you, I don't really know. You know, I kind of just play the game. You know, growing up, I got to watch a lot of the Dodgers, and, you know, like Sean Green was my favorite player growing up, but obviously he's left-handed and stuff. So, you know, I don't really make myself out of, nobody, and kind of just, you know, want to be my own person. And, you know, I'm just very grateful to be here.
Aside from you being a player, now, where the Dodgers are right now, fingers crossed, how exciting is it that fan side of you that grew up rooting for them.
Yeah, it's a surreal, you know, the Dodger game's going on right now, yeah. And you know, unfortunately I don't get to watch it, but I know those guys will take care of business tonight, and if they don't, then you know we'll go back to LA with the 3-2 lead, and you know we're in the driver's seat, and you know, like growing up, just you know, going to those playoff games was a lot of fun, and yeah, man, I get to see those guys during spring training and the off season and stuff when I go over to the stadium. So, you know, all those guys work super hard, and you know, they definitely deserve it.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Of course, thank you.